Before I say something, I would like to start with a couple of questions to you. How many of you would like to get out of this country if you are granted an American visa? Will you kindly raise your hands? Anybody who is willing to get out of this country, if you get a visa. I know Donald Trump, I can get you a visa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, not bad. Not many people. One more question. How many of you would like to become politicians? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. Not difficult to understand the reasons which prompted those of you who raised the hands for both the questions. All of you perhaps, all those who raise the hands, those who want to get out of this country, believe that things are not very happy here, therefore you want to get out of this place and go to US. And you believe that everything is very pleasant and wonderful there in US. Maybe it's slightly better than India, no doubt about it. The material comforts are available. You have better roads, better motor vehicles, better transport services, so forth, so on and so forth. But they have their own problems. There's one country in this world where anybody can shoot anybody anywhere just for the heck of it. Also, and then in this country, it's still not happening. Second, not many people are willing to become politicians. My dear young friends, do you realize that all our lives are regulated by politicians? If we are sitting here today discussing freely, it's because the politicians feel it's a harmless activity by us, therefore they don't stop us. But the minute they perceive that this kind of a gathering can create political trouble to them, the politician would move in, stop this activity. Maybe they'll take us to the prison. A lot of other things can happen. Each aspect of our life is decided by politicians. Still, you youngsters, educated youngsters, are not many of you, most of you are not willing to become politicians. I'm not saying that all of you should get into politics, contest elections and so on. Politics need not necessarily mean contesting an election. Politics is taking interest in public issues. Talking about public issues, talking about the problems of the society, trying to find out solutions from the problems of, for the problems of the society is politics, according to me. Somebody asked me when I retired, what next after your retirement? Are you entering politics? I told them, if you mean politics, by politics you mean contesting an election? No, I'm not into politics. But I believe I'm in politics because so long as an individual speaks, thinks about and speaks about public issues, public problems, that individual is in politics. If that is the definition, I am in politics. So please remember, it's not such a horrible occupation as it's made out nowadays in this country. Or perhaps all over the world, politics has never been the preferred occupation of the best minds. Notwithstanding the fact, occasionally you get a wonderful mind into politics and then they create history. They are the people who make history. Reason is, it's a very hard job. You get a job, your life is comfortable. You get a job, you get a salary, a monthly salary is assured. Your material comfort, the material comforts of your family and dear, near and dear ones are taken care of. A politician's life is not so comfortable in the sense until he succeeds. He becomes a representative of the people, either an MLA or a member of the parliament, and further minister something. It's a hard job. It's a struggle to convince people that he is the right person to be chosen by them. Therefore, perhaps most of us are not willing to enter that area. But in the process, what happens is, since it's a hard job and it's a difficult job to convince people that you are the right person to be chosen, people resort to shortcuts. I presume that the gathering consists of not only Telugu-speaking students, but students from various other parts of the country. I don't want to ask you the question, trouble you, but I'll tell you an anecdote. About a year back, there was a small gathering like this in Delhi. Some gathering of older people of my age group. Most of them were retired civil servants at various levels, mostly at a very higher level. The topic of the debate was the Indian Constitution and its functioning. In the process, a former Chief Election Commissioner of India, a gentleman called Mr. Brahma, in fact, he belonged to Andhra Pradesh Cadre. Eventually, he became the Chief Election Commissioner. He said, look here, there's something going wrong with this country. People spend about 50 crores to become members of the parliament. Poor man, he didn't know the truth. Perhaps there are people who spend much more, double the amount than that to become members of the parliament. When he made this statement, most of the people in the gathering smiled. That's the trouble. So when my turn came, I pointed out this. See, look here, this is the root cause of all the problems in this country. And when a responsible man who knew what is going on makes a statement that people spend 50 crores to become, and my dear children, the law imposes a restriction on this amount that could be spent in an election. The ceiling is very, very, very 50 times less than what is actually being spent. When somebody makes a statement authoritatively that this much of amount is being spent, we don't take a serious note of it, we start smiling. And then we expect everything to run wonderfully well in this country. We don't want corruption. We want everything to run very efficiently. We want a wonderful country. Since all this is not there, we want to run away to America, as if everything is going to be fine there. Now, one choice is to run away. But all of us don't get, I told you a falsehood. I don't know Donald Trump. I never met him. I don't think he would ever look at me also. There's no magic by which all of you could get visas to go to America. You'll have to live here. Most of you will have to live here. Very few lucky might be able to go to US and settle down there. If you have to live here in this country, you better do something about it. Well, our generation, whether we did or did not do, attempted or did not attempt to do, it's a matter of record and history. You know what's going on here. But you are the future of this country. From tomorrow onward, in various areas, you will be playing a role in molding the future of this country. Please take interest not only in the respective areas of your educational training. Please remember always that it is the civil society which determines the quality of the governance in this country. It is the awareness of the civil society. It is the value system of the civil society ultimately which is reflected in every institution in this country. When this program started, I heard two young boys singing, both of them, they said they are from Rajasthan. Unfortunately, my knowledge of Hindi is very limited, though I can broadly understand, I can't speak. Broadly, I could understand. That one line really attracted my attention when they were singing Kabir's rendition. Don't ask a saint about his jat, his caste. That's the greatest problem of this country. The sooner we get rid of this consideration, this caste, this is not going to solve any problem in this country. On the other hand, this is going to create more and more and more problems in this country. And the entire electoral system, our entire administration starts revolving around this one stupid consideration of community. Unless we get rid of this, situations are not going to improve. Now, as I was sitting here, a couple of youngsters came, one young girl, She said she is from Jharkhand, if I remember right, another gentleman, young boy from Hyderabad. Well, they said something nice to me. Since I'm here to address you, since I was a former judge, and the context in which these youngsters were sort of saying those nice things to me, obvious about my press conference of January 12th. Press conference is a different matter. But the point is, I don't know to what extent you youngsters realize the importance of a democratic political system. And in the modern educational system, I don't know, my dear friend Rataya, to what extent he is encouraging you to study social sciences simultaneously, if not from the point of view of the examination. You know something? In the medieval ages, as late as in 17th century, there were areas in this country where a criminal, a perceived criminal, when the state believes somebody is a criminal, well, depending upon the legal system they have, some adjudication is made. People were killed. They used to stuff gunpowder into the ears of the criminal and ignite it. Are you aware of this? Is anybody sitting here in the youngsters aware of it? No. This is what would happen in an undemocratic society. The one who is wielding the power could decide things arbitrarily and do uncivilized acts. And those of the children here who speak Telugu, I'm sure in other languages also the equivalent is there. Those children who speak Telugu, how many of them are here, Telugu speaking? Quite a few. Telugu lo, tol olustan ani cheppi oka expression undi vinuntaru kada? Annara? Ante emoto ardham telusina meeku evarikaina? I'll, for the benefit of those who can't understand Telugu, I'll translate it. There is a threat in Telugu language, which I'm sure in other languages also must be there. I'll flay you alive, skin you alive. And Hindi, I think some chamda utar thing, something, some such thing. I'm not very comfortable with Hindi, but something like that. You know the origin of this threat. There was a particular Sultan of Delhi. That man was very notorious. There may be many others who practiced this. One of his favorite punishments is skinning a man alive. Just peel off the skin when a man is still alive. This is a punishment officially given by the ruler. This kind of things would happen in undemocratic societies. With all its shortcomings and disadvantages, democracy still has certain good quality. But these things can't happen very easily. Of course, we totally stop taking interest in public life. We don't care for what is happening, what the rulers are doing. Then, of course, even in a democracy, these things can happen. So therefore, my dear friends, please take some interest in the administration of the country. As I told you in the beginning, you don't have to contest the elections, but keep a watch on it. When things go wrong, please raise your voice. That is the beauty of democracy. Democracy allows you to speak. Unless you give up that right, you stop. Naturally, if you give up that right, over a period of time, the rulers will take it for granted that they have you have no right at all to speak. They'll always allow a situation like that, because speaking out means criticism. No ruler ever liked criticism. Irrespective, forget about the name of the parties, all the political parties, whatever is the name, no political party ever liked criticism. They'll never like in future also. But if you want to have a dignified life, if you want to have a safe living in this society, in this country, you must at least speak up when you perceive that something is going wrong. You don't have to go and shout on the streets like what is going on in Kerala right now about Shabarimala. There's another tamasha that's going on there. At least you must speak up, raise your voice, right? Nowadays, you're all technocrats. Social media is available to you. One, just a few punches on the mobile phone, you can communicate with the whole of the world. Please do that. And governments, any government, would be worried about public opinion. Ultimately, it's the vote. It matters what people think about. Therefore, the minute people start thinking about and people start expressing their views, governments get worried and maybe there is a possibility of their correcting themselves. So, most essential thing in a democratic society is that the citizenry should learn to stand up and speak when things go wrong. This is something which I request all of you to kindly understand. Don't simply be happy with getting a degree, walk out of Vijnan campus or whatever, wherever you come from, whichever college you come from, then go search for a job, get. Then afterwards you think everything, but if you don't take interest, if everybody gives up this area, things are going to go far worse. You understand? When somebody is spending about 30 crores, 40 crores to become a member of the legislative body, to expect him to do something, some service to the society without indulging in any kind of wrong things is plain stupidity. He's not going to do anything, he or she is not going to do anything for us. Because he'll have to recover the expenditure which he had already incurred. He'll have to get ready for the next election, he'll have to spend money for that. So he'll be busy for the next 5 years on that activity, he'll never bother about us. All this happens because the right-minded people do not take interest in public affairs and administration. So therefore, on an occasion like this, since I told you, I was really wondering what is it that I have to speak here. I thought this is the best thing I can tell you youngsters on an occasion like this. Anyway, I think my time is up. Thank you.